Hi, how are you doing? In this video, we are going to discuss our second example in bilinear transformation. If you have not subscribed to this channel, hit the subscribe button down below and also remember to share the link to the videos to other engineering students. It will also help if you watch the videos online as the channel will grow and therefore I'll be in a position to make more content for you, especially in engineering mathematics and other areas in electrical engineering. In this example, we are told it's October, November 2017, that is electrical engineering, and it's question 3B. We are told the circle which has a radius 2 in the Z plane is mapped onto the W plane by the transformation W is equal to Z plus J over 2Z plus J. And we are told to determine the image of the circle in the W plane. We also told to determine the center and the radius of the image. These are second example. And in the previous example, we have seen in the previous video, we saw that the transformation, the bilinear transformation, is of the form AZ plus B over CZ plus B. If you have not watched the video for the first example and the one that I've explained various types of transformations, watch it on the link shown here, where you can see a circle with a little eye inside it. To give you the link to the video and also to some more videos. We know that the equation of a circle with a center on the origin, equation of a circle, with center at the origin is, the equation of a circle at the origin is x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Our circle has a radius 2, so x squared plus y squared is equal to 2 squared, which is 4, because the radius is 2. I think I'm writing my 2 like a Z, so let me write it properly. We can also draw that circle on the Cartesian plane. So it is a circle with a radius 2. This origin point 0, 0 is 2, positive 2. This y axis, this x axis is negative 2, this is again negative 2. This is when the circle, this equation is when the circle has its center at the origin. Otherwise, if the center of the circle is not at the origin, the equation will not exactly be like this, but it will be something close to this. Is equal to Z plus J over 2Z plus J. What is the value of J? But not J but Z. Z is equal to X plus J Y. So you can make those substitutions. That video is equal to Z is X plus J Y plus J is J over 2 in bracket X plus J Y plus this J. This will give us X plus J Y plus J over 2X plus 2JY, after opening this bracket here, plus J. I think we can separate the real and the imaginary, and we say, have a bracket to separate them, X plus X plus, let me factor out the J. I have y plus 1 over 2x. If I factor out the j here, j it will be 2y plus 1. 2y plus 1. So I will take this w is equal to let me do this. Let me first of all like the whole of it. I do not want to skip a step and then it becomes a problem. 2x plus j plus 2y. I've just written everything in the way it was initially. I've not made any changes. So now I want to rationalize the denominator. What does it mean? I want to multiply the lower side with its complex coordinate. If I multiply the lower side with the complex coordinate, of course I have to multiply the upper side. So I multiply the complex coordinate. The complex conjugate of 2x plus j to bracket 2y plus 1 is 2x minus j to bracket 2y plus 1 as a complex conjugate. Be this in complex numbers. 2x minus the same expression jy j 2y plus 1 j 2y 2y plus 1. Now open the bracket. W is equal to, now I'm opening the bracket, I'm multiplying this with this. X times 2x, 2x squared, x times this is negative x j. I can have j back. Let me start with the j. X times this, it is j x 2y plus 1 bracket. Now this times this is plus j 2x bracket y plus 1. Finally, this times this is negative j times j, j squared. This j and this j into bracket y plus 1 bracket 2y plus 1. But we know that j squared is equal to negative 1. So here we have negative times negative 1 to give us a positive. Then we have this step, just in that positive 1. Or simply positive. On the lower side, we know multiplying a complex number with this complex conjugate will give you a real number. But here it's not a number actually, it's just an expression. So this one, when you multiply with its complex conjugate, it is simply the real part squared plus the imaginary part squared. The real part is 2x squared, that it will give you 4x squared. The imaginary part is 2y plus 1. So it will be plus bracket 2y plus 1, and then we square that. Next step is w is equal to. Let us now open this bracket. We open this bracket, we open this bracket, and this bracket. It is 2x squared, jx times 2y, it is minus because of this negative sign, j2xy, jx times negative 1 minus jx, simply jx, this times 1, plus jx times 2y, it is j 2xy, positive j 2x times 1, it is simply positive 2x, positive j 2x, now we multiply with 1, plus y times 2y, it is 2y squared, y times 1, simply y, 1 times 2i, siempre 2i. And 1 times 1, it's siempre 1. Not that. So we have 4x here. 4x squared. Let us expand this. We expand this, it will be 4y squared plus 2y times 1, 2y times 2, 4y. 4y. Then 1 squared. And 1 squared. 1 squared is this. This is just 1. We can now. What can we combine? What can we combine in order to be equal to 0? If you add this positive, this negative, these two will give us 0. Can disappear. Is there anything else? Only if there is anything else disappearing. So we have W is equal to. I want the 2x squared and the 2y squared to be the first one. 2x squared plus 2y squared. So I've taken care of that. Other here, let us combine other here. See, y plus 2y is 3y. So plus 3y. I've taken care of what? Of that and that. This one is 0. Plus 1. Also taken care of that. So what else? This is imaginary. And this is imaginary. We can combine them. They will give us jx plus 2jx. It will be simply positive jx plus jx over. And here is 4x squared. 4x squared plus 4y squared plus 4y plus 1. The only thing on the right side is zero. We can now, because I think we have said this already, we already made ourselves. W is equal to U plus JV. And we also know that X squared plus Y squared is equal to 4. X squared. So we call that W is equal to U plus JV and X squared plus Y squared is equal to what? 4. This one. So let us make those two substitutions in this expression, in this equation. So we have U plus JV, where you have W. U plus JV in place of W. 2x squared plus 2y squared. I should have factored that. But we can factor out. Let us factor out the 2. I have the 2. X squared plus y squared. After factoring. X squared plus y squared. That is factored out. 3y plus 1. 3y plus 1 plus jx over 4 into bracket x squared plus y squared. If only factor that up here plus 4y plus 1. So u plus jv is equal to 4 x squared plus y squared is equal to 4 times 2, 8 plus 3y plus 1 plus jx. X squared plus y squared 4 times 4, 16 plus 4y plus 1. This is collected in the next step. U plus JV is equal to, or separate the little part No, the real part and the imaginary part, I'll write them separately. It is, but first I should combine the 1 with 8 to give me 9 plus 3y, all of it over what? 1 plus 16, 17, plus 4, plus 4y, plus jx over the real part, which is, I mean the denominator, which is 17 plus 4. So now you can equating the real and imaginary parts on both sides of the equation. On both sides of the equation. On both sides of the equation. So what is u? U, this is the real and u is real. So u is equal to 9 plus 3y over 17 plus 4y. 9 plus 3y over 17 plus 4y. What about v? Is a imaginary, this is imaginary. When you equate that, the j is cancelled. So v is equal to x over 17 plus 4y. Using the above two equations, make x and y the subject of the formula. Let us start with the first one. The first one is simpler. The equation for u, because it has only y's. We start with the equation for v. You will have a problem because you have both x and y. So which one will you make the subject? Which one will you make the subject of the formula and you have both? It will be tough for you. So start with this one. You can say u is equal to 9 plus 3y over 17 plus 4y. Cross multiply u with bracket 17 plus 4y is equal to 9 plus 3y. Yes, you can move this, there's no problem. Final bracket 17u plus 4uy plus 9, not plus but equal to 9 plus 3y. Make y to be on one side. 4y, 4uy minus 3y is equal to 9 minus 17u. Factor out y, 4u minus 3 is equal to 9 minus 17u. Divide both sides by 4u minus 3. Y is equal to 9 minus 17u over 4u minus 3. So we have obtained the first value, which is the value of y. We now go ahead and try to substitute this value we have obtained on. Okay, maybe first, it's like this. So So you already have white. V is equal to x over 17 plus 4y. Then cross multiply. This is V into bracket 17 plus 4y is equal to x. Open that bracket. 17v is equal to 4b, not 4 equal to, plus 17b plus 4v, y is equal to x. I think now we can, if there is something I've missed, it's okay. So now 17v plus 4b, I thought it's the value of y. 9 minus 17u over 4u minus 3, close that bracket. So that is the value of y is equal to x. Let us open the bracket. We have 17v plus multiply 4v times 9 is that a 6v? At 6v, 4v times 4v times 17. I think I need a calculator. I didn't bring my calculator. Now we can do what? We can multiply through by 4u minus 3. Multiply u e. No, no, we multiply or we find the LCM. Alright, let us multiply. 4u minus 3. We multiply through with that. It is if we multiply here, it is 17 to bracket. 4u minus 3, close that bracket. Suppose this is over 1. Over 1. Over 1. When you multiply here, these and these, you cancel out. So now plus, that is 6v minus 68. VU is equal to 4U minus 3, all that multiplied with what? This x here. Let us open this bracket. 17, I missed this V. 17V, this 17V. Times 4u is 68. In here, we are multiplying 17 with 4 somewhere. This one, we got 68 bu minus 17 times 3 is 21. 17 times 3, this is 21. 51. 51 b. 17b times 3b, 51b plus 36b minus 68b is equal to 4u minus 3, close that bracket with an x. So here we have negative 68bu and we have positive 68bu. I think this one can combine to give us a 0. So now we have what? We have 15, 51, and 36. Isn't this negative 15 is equal to 4u minus 3x, or simply what? X is equal to negative 15b over for u minus 3. You are going through a lot of trouble. See all these and all quarterback removed before this one. You are only trying to just get two values, the y and the x, so that we can substitute them here. That's why we have to go through all the trouble. So we need to substitute them. What's the value of x? We have it here. Negative 15v over 4u minus 3. You can square that plus y squared. Where is y? 9 minus 17u over 4u minus 3. Again, all these you can square it. Negative 15b, you square this over 4u minus 3, you square that plus 9 minus 17u. We square that over 4u minus 3. We square that is equal to that picture was equal to what? 4. Because I'm taking x, you see, I'm taking x, which is this, I'm squaring here. I'm taking y, which is this one, I'm squaring, as it is supposed to be squared here. Then I'm getting it to 4. So here I'm getting to 4. But this one, remember, is squared. If you square 15, it will be 225 v squared. For time being, let us not bother square this one. If we square it at this point, what? Let us. Is it indeed necessary? Let us not square it for the time being. 4u minus 3 squared. This is quite lengthy. Want to avoid making any mistakes. I think this one should be squared. For the time being, let us square the upper one. If you square this one, it is 9 squared, 81. Let us continue. Now that I have my calculator here. What do you do? We can multiply both sides with. I'm trying to get this 4u minus 3 squared from the lower side. 4u minus 3 squared. So I multiply with both sides. What will happen now? When you are multiplying these and these, you cancel out. So that will be left with 225 v squared plus. By the way, one thing that make you know you are in the right track is the same denominators. Most likely I'm correct because the denominators are the same. I'm not sure whether I'm wrong on the numerator side, but the fact that the denominator is the same gives me hope that I am on the right track. So always check, are you getting similar denominators? So plus, if we multiply this with this, we make that one completely disappear, which will give us 81 minus 306 u plus 289 u squared is equal to what? Is equal to 4. I think, let us open this bracket by squaring. 4, you already know how to do this, a plus b squared. 4u squared is 16u squared. 4u times 3, I mean 4u times negative 3, negative 12u times 2, negative 24. 24u negative 3 squared plus 9. I think there are a lot of in this topic there is a lot of basic concepts that will be so important that you must know of it. For example, we will expand this to this of it. Because in a 3-hour exam, investing your time expanding this in a 3-hour exam, it will really affect your work. You can see we have done quite a lot, and yet we are not there yet. So, now we bring, let us open this bracket. 225 V squared plus 81 minus 306 U plus 289 U squared is equal to 4 times 16, 48 U squared plus minus not plus 4 times 24, that could be 48 times 2, 96, 96 U plus 4 times 9, 36. Always use the calculator whenever necessary, not all the time. What do we do now? Let us do this. We bring the use. Let me start with this U. 289 U squared. You see this U. Because I'm trying to bring everything on this side to the other side. Apart from 36. I'll leave the 36 on this side. So we have 48 U squared, subtracting this U. I'll start with all U's. Then you have 306 U. 306 U. This one. Plus 96 U. But this one, when you get the other side, it will be positive. Plus 96 U. What else? We are done with U because you have taken care of this one, this one, this one, this one. Now we can write down the value of V. Plus 225 V squared. What else? This 81. I don't do this. This 81, take it to the other side of the equation. There is 36 already. 36 plus, no, positive. On the other side, it will be negative. So, negative 81. Let us do the maths. I missed something here, but there was this 48. I should have put it here. This 48 minus 48 U squared minus 306 U plus 96 U plus what? Two two five V squared is equal to what? Is that 6? And bring the 81 on the other side of the equation to be negative 81. Let us now combine. Do the math. 289 minus 48. 241. Let's see. 289 minus 48. 241. Should be 225. So that it can be similar to this square. There must be a problem somewhere. I don't know where. Where did we get this? 48. 4 times 16. No, 64. It's 64. I got my offering to get 48, but it's 16. Always check. If this 225 is 225, if for you it's not 225, then you know you have a problem somewhere. That's a good thing of knowing what you expect in advance. You can always sense when you are making a mistake. 4 times 16 is 64. I made that mistake. So I collect here 64. But it's good to see me make mistakes so that you can say, oh, here I can make mistake, I'll be careful. So yeah, this is 64. 64. So is it now, will it work? 289 minus 64 Now I'm sure I'm correct. Because this when I subtract, I'll get 225 u squared. 306 plus this is minus 306. Negative 306 plus 86 is equal to negative 210. 210 u. My friends say my English is like my local language. So I'm pronouncing this like they are doing my language. 210 u. What else? We have combined these two. So we have taken care of u plus 225 v squared is equal to, see that 6 minus 4, 3 was 81. This 81 is not part of this, is 1. So you have 36 minus 81, negative 45. This is negative 45. So what do we do now? See the fact that coefficient of u and coefficient of v both are 225. We are sure, not very sure, but we are very confident we are heading on the right direction. Even if there is a mistake, maybe here 45 or 210. There could be a mistake, but the fact that we have 225 u squared and 225 v squared, we are very hopeful we are in the right direction, because when you divide by 225, both of them, their coefficient would be 1. If you have one of them, its coefficient is not 1, start checking. Where did I go wrong before you proceed with the question? Because there is no way you'll be able to finish the question when their coefficients is not the same. So if you divide through by 225, dividing through by 225. So this is u squared, 210 minus 210 divided by 225 u plus v squared is equal to negative 45 divided by 225. What would be the common factor here? We have 210 by 5, 210 divided by 5 is 42. I think common factor could be 42. U squared is equal to, not is equal to, but minus 42 over 225 divided by 5 is 45. 45 plus v squared is equal to, here we divide by 5, it will be negative 9 over 45. I think we can divide again by 9. In fact, you should divide through by 5. My memory filled up and the camera was not recording. So I had done all this up to here and it was not recorded. So this one, this part I will explain, I'll not repeat it. So here I was saying, you divide here by 45 by 45, negative 1 by 45, 235 by 45, 5. And then this part, you have to complete the square. Complete the square for this part. Completion of square is a method that you did right from your high school. I mean, right from high school. Form 1, form 2, form 3, somewhere there. I think you did record. So here you have to remember that method, it's very important. This is a 3-hour exam. This part, you should do it offhand. Of course, it takes some time if you have to follow all the steps. Our leader advises you, practice this method of completion of squares if you want to get these marks as quickly as possible. Remember, you want this one to be one of your, the question, one of the questions that you do as fast as possible, so that you can move on to more time-consuming questions like Fourier series. So make sure you are very good, very perfect in this method, completion of squares. So let us complete a square. To complete a square, we will need have the coefficient of u. The coefficient of u is 42 over 45. If you divide that, you get 21 over 45. Or you multiply, we can either say multiply by a half or divide by 2. So you get 21 over 45. Then you add the square of half coefficient of u on both sides of the equation. That half coefficient of u that you have just obtained in this step, you square it to get this. And then you add that on both sides of the equation. So you have u squared minus 42 over 4, minus 42 over 45 u, u squared minus 42 over 45 u plus the square of half the coefficient, which is this square of half the coefficient plus v. We have said add it on both sides of the equation. So this one I've also added it here. And this step, I was trying to do what? I was trying to, what was I trying to do? I think I was just trying to do the combination. Yeah, I was trying to add this one to this one. And my way of method, I always try to avoid using LCM. My method of doing things much faster is making them to have the same denominator. So I made 45 divided by 2025. 5 years from now, 2025, will give you, this divided by this will give you negative 5, negative 1 over 5. So I've not made any changes. Try on your calculator, 405 divided by 2025 is negative 1 over 5. So it's just the same. If you want to use LCM, it works faster for you. If LCM works faster for you, use LCM. This is my method, you don't have to use it if you don't like it. But here, you can use LCM. On combining these two, I got this. Find it as a perfect square. Write this complete square as a perfect square. This one is already a complete square and is in the form of a perfect square. So there's nothing here you are going to do. Our focus is on this part. If you are trying this is a perfect square, it is u minus, you see the half coefficient we are talking about, 21 over 45, then you square that. So I've taken u plus half the coefficient here, but the sign is minus, so minus half the coefficient, and then I square plus v squared is equal to this one that sits. I can also write it as a something square. This must be that 6. That 6, if you find the square root is 6. Square root of 4, 2025 is what? Let me check with my calculator here. Root of, I don't know whether it's somewhere I've done it. Root of 2025. Root of 2025. This is 45. 45. But now it is squared. Whatever I'm doing, I'm rewriting this expression as we had said in the earlier video. You have not watched the video, watch it on the link shown above. You see a small circle with an eye incident. When you click this circle with an eye incident, it will give you a link to my first video, to my first example. I have already explained. Here we are, this expression, when we have written it in like this, we cannot really know what is the center of the circle, what is the radius of the circle. But when we write it like this, this is called the center radius format. This equation of a circle, the same equation of the circle, we are writing it in center radius format. So this will bring us to know the center of the circle and the radius of the circle. In my first video, the first example, I also made a mistake. I had explained it, but the memory went down, so I'll explain again. I said that in the previous example, I had, you see here where you have the half the coefficient. I mean, you see where you have the coefficient of u. I used half the coefficient here, which was wrong. I should have only used half the coefficient here. So check that video, I made that mistake. I do not want it to confuse you. Here you are not supposed to use half the coefficient. Here you are not supposed to use half the coefficient. Here you are not supposed to use half the coefficient. You are supposed to use the coefficient the way it is. You are supposed to use the half the coefficient here only.
The equation of a circle is expressed in center radius format S. You know that use to be, you can use variable X if you use working with variable X, you can use variable U, or you can use any other variable. I'm working with U, so I'll use variable U. U minus H plus V minus K is equal to R squared. H is the coordinate for the u-axis, k is the coordinate for the v-axis, r is the square, r squared is the square of the radius. We have, our expression is u, so we have u minus 21 over 45. Will we divide this by something? I think we should have divided by 3. Should have given us what? 21 divided by 3, 7, 7 over 15. I want it divided both sides by 3, 3. By 3, 7, by 3, 15. I think I should have done that way back. But it's no problem. Plus, you see, this square. Oh, this square, I mean square, this square. This must be squared, this must be squared, is equal to R squared. So V squared, see V squared, eh? Is simply V minus 0 squared. V squared is V minus 0 squared, is equal to 6 over 45 squared. This means what we have inside. What you have inside, I almost broke my finger, what you have inside is the radius. This is coordinate for v-axis, this is a coordinate for u-axis. You can see. This is the equation of a circle. This is the equation of a circle with center what? So if this is negative, here is positive. Take it when it's positive. 7 over 15, 0. This is the equation of a circle with center that at radius, what you have inside here is the radius, 6 over 45. Then this one you can simplify to what? By 3, 2, by 45, 15. By 3, 2, so it is 2 over 15. I think that's what I got, you can say. Things like that. So now we can say, we can do plot here. That circle in the z plane or something of the sort. This y axis, this z, so this z plane. On the z plane, we use the x and y axis. Because we know z, z is equal to x plus jy. 2, the radius is 2, so we expect from the center, is from this point, this is the radius, this is the radius, so this is 2, this is the radius, so this is negative 2, this is the radius, so this is negative 2. This one is being transformed. Notice this is equation of a circle. The moment you see u squared, v squared, is equation of a circle. If one of them is not squared, it means that it's not a circle. Maybe something close to a circle, but not inside a circle. From that, we are sure it's a circle because we have even managed to express it in center radius format. But this angle is quite small. You can see the radius is small. 2 over 15 units. 2 over 15 units. And the center of the circle is this V axis, this U axis. The effect of this J factor is turning a vector by 90 degrees. So the J factor turns the vector by 90 degrees. So the angle between U and X, the angle between Y and X is 90. The same case here, you know that W is equal to U plus JV. J, the effect of this J vector, I mean the effect of J is to turn the vector by 90 degrees. So V will be here, V will be here. This is a real, this is an imaginary axis, this is a real axis. So the value of V is 0, we are on this line, V is 0, and the value of U is 7 over 15. 7 over 15, I don't know how it will be there. For V is 0, so it's here. The radius is 2 over 15, so a very small circle. A very small circle. So you can see the transformation W is equal to what? W is equal to Z plus J over 2Z plus J manages to transform a circle on the Z plane to another circle on the W plane. So the image is also a circle. But this circle one is a magnification, is magnified but reduced in size. We also notice how are the points marked? I usually like using zero. When I'm checking how the points are marked, zero is one of the best to use. You see here you have Z plane, Z plane, W plane. The equation on the W plane is W is equal to Z plus J over 2Z plus J. So here we have point, you take point 0, 0, take Z is equal to X0, Y0, or simply point 0, 0. The image here will be that point, the same point, let me call it W, it will be the origin, we call it A, B or whatever. So this will be 0 plus J, as J, this is J over J, is equal to 1. So this circle, 1 is here. So it means the origin is marked from where it is to that point, 1. Outside the circle, notice it is outside the circle. Using this point 0, 0, we have seen it's being marked outside the circle. So it appears that most of the points here are being marked outside the circle. You can see points inside the circle. In the Z plane are marked as points outside the circle
in the W plane. Of course, you should take more points for that consideration. I've only used 1 point.
But I don't think in the exam you really have time to try several points.
I think in the exam, this conclusion, don't want to waste so much time
trying to prove really that it is inside the circle. Don't waste a lot of time.
Just use 1 point, like 0, 0. For the purpose of the exam, because it's a 3-hour exam,
you cannot spend all your time trying to prove something and you have more questions to attempt, especially when you try this as your second example, not as your second. I always suggest this one should be the third exam, the third question in the exam. If this is your third question in the exam, fully a series is still waiting for you, plus another one more question. Do not try a lot of points. Just try 0, 0. Use this screen that you are seeing right now as a link to more videos that you have not watched.